15th of May. Approximate time is 18:48. You can see I'm here with all my fans. You know, I'm just on my own. Not the busiest night here at the Trafford Athletic Club in Stretford. Now, every other Tuesday there is time trials through majority of the athletic distances. Some of you may know, some of you may not. I have four world records. Three of them are broken, from the mile, half marathon, and the marathon world record. And the 400 metres, which I've set officially at 60.95 seconds a few weeks ago at Northwood Athletic Stadium. Now, I have done sub 60, 59.48 seconds at Cumberland about 4 weeks approximately ago. With five witnesses, wasn't filmed, that's another reason why I'm here. So, I want to be officially the first to break sub 60 seconds with a 40 pound pack. Cameraman Julian Clare, say hello, Julian.
How do?
You alright?
Yeah, mate.
Come and show the camera your face. Yeah. Julian's going to be one of the witnesses.
Alright.
Cheers, Julian.
No worries.
We're just going to weigh the pack now.
Yep.
Yeah, 40 pounds. Which you weigh before and after the record attempt?
1.3, 41.2, 40.9, 40.92.
Right, very happy with that, guys. So, just to show you. Is that on, Julian?
That's on that.
Yeah, 40.92. The three weigh-ins, two of them out of the three over 40 pounds. It's not going to get much more official than that. Matt Harris just told me, hand time, 59.5. That'll do. But I don't know yet. Felt good, I hope. I'm hoping. Really hoping. I think I've done it. Fingers crossed, come on. Come on, please, let it be my day for once. Let it be the day. Okay. Hand time, I can say 59.5. Praying to God. Rob, introduce yourself, Rob.
Rob Valentine from South Cheshire Harriers.
And Rob's just going to witness with us all now the weighing of the pack post the event. Just make sure he's over 40 pounds. There you go. 40.16. Anyway, weigh in was 40.16 post event. Fingers crossed to the result. Thank you. Right, okay, post event. Bloody done it! Okay, lane one. Well, he's number six on there, but lane one. 59.44. Yeah,
well done, Lee. That's without doubt the best of your records that you've set.
This is John Donahue.
Right.
He's holding the photo finish. Okay.
Hi, Mark Hartley from Staff Smallands. So you just seen Lee Riley break the world record for the 40-pound backpack on his back, 400 metres. Absolutely fantastic run by Lee there. Went through 200, just under 30 seconds, managed to hold it all together. Come through 400, just under 60 seconds. Absolutely fantastic. event needed to use so much power and strength to get through. Great run.
I just want to say, guys, while you're all watching this, okay, John can feel the weight at 40 pounds. Well, that's a bit over dramatic there.
I could not get around 400 metres with this on my back, to be honest. Certainly not run around.
John is a good runner, by the way. I just want to say to everyone, to make this official, this is the first ever, I'm the first ever person to break sub 60 with a 4-pound pack. You know, that's what I wanted, and hope this goes to some way in the future of supporting soldiers furthermore, and through the charities including the Royal British Legion, helping the Royal Marines, you know. Once a Marine, always a Marine. Don't want to drop my standards, only improve. Yeah, you're never too young, and like I always say, you never know what you've got left even when you die, because you don't know, do you? So keep it going. See you later.
What's the next goal?
Well, Rob, after living a dream another day, or making a dream as we do, the next goal is the 5K, 5,000 metres. That's going to be on the track.
Yeah.
Now, just for the record as well, the record is 20 minutes, 6 seconds. I forget his name, but he's held in the States, you know, in America.
Yeah.
So I'm going to take on the Americans and I'm going to annihilate it. I need to crack this. I want to wrap all the, you know, records, including the 10K up. Then I'll have the set.
Yeah.
I'll be the undisputed 40-pound pack running champion of all time. So that's the plan. Sub 5-minute mile to be the first ever, just like the sub 60. You know, if anyone, I've done this feat now under 400 days, the 400s, you know, the half marathon, mile and marathon. If anyone could do this to break all the records I've done within the 400 days, then good luck to you. Because that's been my strength, the all-round endurance and the persistence. Training as an amateur and juggling a job at the same time. My mum and dad are a massive motivation. My mum helps me massively on my food, supports me. You know, thank God she's here. She had a heart attack, bad one recently, and thank God she just started last night back into the fitness regime. The Royal British Legion of the Crew Branch support me massively. I've raised over £2,000 collectively, including them and the Soldiers Charity, since I've started on my own for the last 12 months. You know, every day can be a very groundhog day, you know, 9 to 5 people work, you know, you've got to do things, strive to challenge, actually make yourself tick and have some meaning in life. So today is a very, very special day that no one can take away from me. This is the most amazing thing of the feeling of doing this, is the fact that I haven't done it first time and I wouldn't give up. I've had to change my training tactics, I've gone over distance, I've gone under the distance. You know, but I haven't done typical 400 meter training to achieve that, all sorts of things. And I'm ongoing, my learning curve is going up, you know, so next will be the middle distance category. You know, I'm not 31 yet, that's November. This is the Olympic year, you know, let's not rest on your laurels, you know, and now is a time for celebration. So enjoy. Thank you very much, everybody. It means the world to me, this. Thank you.
It just so happens that I've set the fastest ever 400 metres, have gone sub 60 seconds with a 40-pound pack. And Steve can obviously...
I can't even lift it.
He can, he's acting a bit. But no, it's equivalent to just under 3 stone, like carrying or running with 2 car tyres on your back. It just so happens that my next challenge is the sub 5-minute mile with the greatest ever British miler next to me.
You'll be doing it by yourself. Well, good luck is all I can say, because that is heavy. And all it's making me do is think I'm not going to put weight on, because I've got definitely no chance of running. But yeah. And do you train with that?
Yeah, I do a lot of training with it off. But obviously you don't want to have too much injury, you know, when you're pounding the streets. I mean, on camera, while we're going on telly, I wanted to ask Mr. Steve Cram here if he'd pace me. I asked him earlier on a sub 5-minute mile.
If you want to run sub 5 minutes, you need to get somebody else. But I wouldn't be able to run that fast. I wouldn't be able to help you, to be honest, because I can't even run a 5-minute mile these days. And I know you can't believe that, but it's the absolute truth. So, but I'll happily come and support you, and I'll try to whenever you decide to do it.
You
need to go to one of the big meets, you know, like the BMC or something like that, and get a couple of the good lads to help you out. That's where you should go and try.
I mean, obviously, I want to, if the BMC would allow me, because obviously, sometimes you might not take serious a guy running with a pack.
No, if you, I mean, obviously, because the graded races, if you're in the right sort of race, then
I'm sure they'll be happy to let you
Even though I'm obviously well over the time, you still think...
Yeah, well, the BMCs are... You don't have to go to the Grand Prix ones. There are lower-level ones where people are running those sort of times. I mean, obviously, it's a mile you want to do, so whereas this is technically 600 meters, so you probably have to find one over the mile.
Yeah.
Good luck.
No, it's absolutely fantastic.
I did. I came in just as you were setting off, and I thought, I wondered what. And then I heard them say somebody was carrying 3 stone on the back, so I wasn't quite sure what it was all about, but yeah.
Right.
It's pretty impressive. There's
something I have to do to round off one of the greatest days of my life, having smashed a challenge that most people would never even dream being able to do. I want people to realise out there, and all the fellow Royal Marines, okay, this is my background, this is where I've come from. Yeah, Marines are ordinary Joes, yeah, they can do extraordinary things. And as our Prince Philip, the Duke of Edinburgh, once said, Marines, you know, can do the impossible. And I, for once, you know, can say what I've done tonight. It blooming means the world to me, this. Yeah. To earn this green beret, as all Marines, some people know, it's the longest, hardest initial training in the world. And even though I've been out now 5 years, I feel as fit and as fresh as ever, once have at 30 years old. To me, Royal Marines Commandos is what it's all about. It's the best thing I've ever done in my life, and the best club I've ever joined. Yeah, nothing can ever take this away. I'm on fire, fit as fire, can't believe it. I've tried to write to Steve Cram for months. I've tried to get hold of Seb Coe and Peter, and he's busy with the Olympics. He just turned up as I finished my world record. He saw half of it, can't believe it. I'm just on a so happy. You know, when you put so much into things, when you train so hard and something comes off like this, life is a brilliant thing. You know, all I want now is a rival, someone in America, Europe, Australia, wherever, to challenge me running with this weight. You know, I found someone I'm good at. There's always somebody better, somebody else out there who are. Thank you so much, everybody, for the support. You know, really means everything. So watch out there for what I'm going to be coming up. Because me, as I always say, at the moment in life, this is just the start. You know, who knows what I'm going to achieve in this next decade. I keep surprising myself, and I don't want to stop. I found something just to keep going. There's lots of challenges that you find there that aren't even marketed or advertised. Mountain races, fell running races, desert races, you know, all around the world. It's a shame, like I've said before on camera, that a lot of these athletic events, running events, are not marketed well. People don't know about them. Football's overshadowed. I'm not a football fan. I know a lot of you out there are. But, you know, okay, I can understand why it's so popular. But it just doesn't do it for me, you know. I'm glad we've got a great bloody, England team. But let's be honest, it's not that great. Yeah, we should be bloody winning every bloody game, the amount of money they get. I think it's disgusting. I really do. I think you should all be ashamed of yourselves. You know, I'm not in it for money, because there isn't any money in amateur sports. There isn't any money in athletics. I'm in it for the love, the passion, you know, and I just can't believe what I've done. And this, getting this bit of cloth, is such foundation to make you realise what you can do. You know, don't want to lose this ability. Yeah, it's all in the state of mind. It's all about believing in yourself. It's about constantly challenging yourself. Yep, so keep going, people. Keep doing what you do best. You know, if you find you're good at something, you build on it, you stick with it, and you go for it in life. Thank you.